Students, this is Dr. Roli Verma, Head Chemistry Department, JSS Academy of Technical Education, Noida. In continuation of my previous four lectures, today I am going to deliver a lecture on biodegradable polymers. Up till now, we have already discussed the types of polymers, the different classification. We have seen conducting polymers, how they are utilized, how many types of conducting polymers are there. Today we are going to discuss another category of the polymers that comes under biodegradable polymers. And the learning outcomes of the lecture is you will be able to discuss what biodegradability means and why it is important in context of polymer chemistry. You can list down the different types of biodegradable polymers. You can describe in detail what factors affect the degradation rate of polyesters. Introduction, again I will like to introduce the polymers. You also know that polymer, it is made up of two words, that is polis and morose. Polis meaning many or much, morose meaning parts, and it refers to a molecule whose structure is composed of multiple repeating units. The term polymer was coined in 1833 by Berzelius, and he defined that polymer is a large molecule which is composed of many repeated subunits known as monomers. Monomers can be linked together in various ways to give linear, branched and cross-linked polymers. Now, what are biodegradable polymers? Up till now, the conventional polymers, whatever the conventional polymers we are using, synthetic polymers, they are reasonably stable and they do not undergo degradation. The degradation of conventional polymers take hundreds of years, and in hundreds of years, it is very difficult to degrade the polymer. And the degradation takes place when they are exposed to moisture, heat, oxygen, ozone and microorganisms. Then also, they take long years to get degraded. The agents, either they lead to the breakdown of the chemical structure of the polymer, they result in the change in the properties of the polymer or structural modification. Now, these biodegradable polymers are defined as polymers comprised of monomers linked to have one another through functional groups and have unstable links in the backbone. They are broken down into biologically acceptable molecules that are metabolized and removed from the body via normal metabolic pathways. Based on the biodegradability, polymers are classified as biodegradable polymers, that is natural and synthetic. Generally, biodegradation is the chemical breakdown of the materials by physiological environment. The term is used in relation to ecology, waste management, and environmental remediation. This term is often used when generally organic materials such as plants, animal matters, and other substances which originates from living organism or artificial materials that are similar to plant and animal matters to be put up to use by microorganism. These organic materials can be degraded by various ways. What is the requirement of biodegradable polymers? Today, all of us are bound to think about biodegradable polymers. What is the reason behind that? Basically, there is a huge environmental impact of persistent synthetic plastics. And we know that plastics are one of the most important commodity today. We cannot think our day-to-day life without polymer. We cannot say that polymers are bad. Polymers are good, but we don't know how to manage the plastic waste. That is why now the plastic has turned as a bad or evil structure. Whereas if you see as a part of the application, we can find that huge and large number of applications of the polymers are there, and we are not able to replace the polymers by any other material. Either we need to find a substitute of the polymers, or we need to convert these polymers in biodegradable polymers so that we can enjoy the utilization of these polymers and their applications, the various ways by which they are utilized. Now, it's a global concern. The plastic waste management, it's a global concern. If the plastic waste is burned or incinerated, it is going to generate huge amount of toxic gases like furans, etc., which are very toxic. If we are going to landfill with the plastics, then again we are burying the polymer in the plastic, and ultimately it will leach down all the toxic substances in the land. Then if we think about dumping these polymers in the rivers, then again it's a huge problem, because these polymers, they will not degrade in the oceans also. Now, for your information, I would like to add that these polymers, now they have entered in the food chain also. There are so many types of plastics, you are utilizing microplastics also. You are using nowadays in the fancy cosmetic items, scrubs like of thing, they are containing microplastics, the small granular parts, they are the microplastics only. And these microplastics, when they are washed off, they will go in the drains, and from the drains they will go to river, then they will go to sea, and ultimately they are dumping in the oceans. And they are very vulnerable. These microplastic micro fragmentations, they are very, very, very dangerous in nature, and they will sustain in the water, in the oceans, for a very long period. These polymers or microplastics are consumed by the fishes. They're the shiny materials, and the fishes, they think that it's a food material and they take it as a food. When the fish take these shiny materials, the plastic inside them, that small fish is eaten by the larger fish, the larger fish is eaten by the human beings, and from this way it is entering to the food chain. The another way, those who are non-veg, those who are taking the fishes, if you will check, definitely you can find some polymeric composition in their body. Another way, those who are vegetarians, they are having another source for the plastic in their body. We know the huge application of the sea is the extraction of salts. These microparticles, these micro fragments of the plastics, they settle down in the sea, and they are extracting. When we are extracting the salt, they are coming in that salt also. And all of us utilize these salts in day-to-day food. So you can see that how commonly and how easily the plastic has entered in the food chain. If you test yourself, you will get that polymers are inside your body. The another thing, we don't know how to recycle. I'm not saying that recycling of the polymers is not possible. Recycling is possible, but unfortunately in India it's an expensive aspect, and fueling international it also, and when we are exporting these polymers to other country for the plastic waste management, we are burning lot of money in that. So that is the basic drive to develop biodegradable polymers. We know a huge amount of packaging materials. They are made by these polymers, and then these packaging materials are littering here and there, which causes threat to the environment. The another, or you can say other primary factors which drive the development of biodegradable packaging keh sakte hain or polymers keh sakte hain, is because the conventional polymers, they are derived from the crude oil only. So there's an increase in the prices of crude oil. There's an increase in the consumer demand, proliferation of consumer packaging, development of new applications of bioplastic, and increased economic viability. We know to synthesize polymer at a pilot scale is not a very costly affair. So just by synthesizing in the lab, we are able to get these polymers on a pilot level. Another, we can see that these biodegradable plastics, they can be decomposed by the action of living organisms, usually microbes into water, carbon dioxide, and biomass. Biodegradable plastics are commonly produced with renewable raw materials, microorganisms, petrochemicals, or combinations of all the three. We can also see that these biomaterials can be degraded either by aerobically, that is with oxygen, or anaerobically, that is without oxygen. Biosurfactant, which are surface active substances, they are synthesized by the living cells in an extracellular microorganism, and they are secreted by the microorganism. It enhances the biodegradation process. Some microorganisms have naturally occurring microbial catabolic diversity to degrade, transform, or accumulate a huge range of compounds like hydrocarbons, polyaromatics, polyhydrocarbons, pharmaceutical substances, radionuclides, and metals. The activity of aerobic microbes can be measured by the amount of oxygen they consume or the amount of carbon dioxide they produce. The activity of anaerobic microbes can be measured by the amount of methane or alloy that they may be able to produce. Let's see the classification of this biodegradable polymers, and this classification is based on the source. Depending upon the source, they are divided into four categories. The first one is biomass products, that is agropolymers, and further subdivided into two categories, that is, they may be polysaccharides, they may be proteins. Few examples of polysaccharides are starches, lignocellulic products, others gums, chitosan, etc. The protein, maybe it's an animal protein or it is a plant protein. From microorganism, they are obtained by extraction. Example is polyhydroxy alkanoates, commonly known as PHA. Next category, from biotechnology, conventional synthesis from bio-derived monomers. Example is polylactic acids. And the last category, from the oil products, they are conventional synthesized from synthetic monomers. Example, polycaprolactones, PCL, polyesteramides, PEA, aliphatic copolyesters, PBSA, aliphatic copolyesters, PBAT. Now, these are the structures of some common biodegradable polymers: amylose, cellulose, polyhydroxybutyrate, polylactic acids, polybutyl butylene succinate, polycaprolactone, aliphatic aromatic resins, carboxymethyl cellulose, and thermal polyaspirates. So there are few examples of biodegradable polymers. We will discuss few of them and we'll see that what are the properties they are containing and where they found their applications. So first one is polyglycolic acid, which is also known as commonly known as PGA. It is a biodegradable thermoplastic polymer and the simplest linear aliphatic polyester. It is a tough fiber forming polymer. Due to its hydrolytic instability, its use has been limited. Next, it has a glass transition between 35 to 40 degrees centigrade, crystallinity about 45, melting point is in the range of 225 to 230 degrees centigrade. It is insoluble in water. The polyglycolide is degraded by hydrolysis and broken down by certain enzymes. It founds application in drug delivery systems in the form of microspheres and implants. Some examples of drug delivered includes steroid hormones, antibiotics, anti-cancer agents. This is the commercial application of the PGA, which are available in the market also. You can see the sutures, which are dissolvable. They are available in the market. Next category, the next biodegradable polymer, that is polylactic acid. It is also known as polylactide, commonly PLA. It is a thermoplastic aliphatic polyester derived from renewable resources such as corn, starch, tapioca products, roots, chips or starch, or sugarcane. It can be biodegraded under certain conditions such as presence of oxygen, that is aerobic condition, and it is difficult to recycle. Polylactic acid is highly crystalline, having high melting point, low solubility. The bacterial fermentation is used to produce lactic acid from corn starch or cane sugar. It found application in the preparation of sutures or orthopedic devices. Another category or the polymer is polycaprolactone. Polycaprolactone is a biodegradable polyester having a low melting point of around 60 degrees centigrade. It has a glass transition temperature of about 60 degrees centigrade. It has a slow degradation rate in comparison to polylactic acid. It remains active as long as a year for drug delivery system. It founds application in cyclosporine in the form of nanoparticles, ciprofloxacin in the form of dental implants. Next polymer, commonly known as PHBV, is poly-3-hydroxybutyrate co-3-hydroxyvalerate. It is a polyhydroxyalkanoate polymer. It is biodegradable, non-toxic, biocompatible plastic produced naturally by bacteria. A good alternative for many non-biodegradable synthetic polymers. It is a thermoplastic linear aliphatic polyester. It is obtained by the copolymerization of 3-hydroxybutanoic acid and 3 hydroxy pentanoic acid. PHBV found application in specialty packaging, orthopedic devices, and in controlled release of drugs. PHBV undergoes bacterial degradation in the environment. Now let us see what are the factors which affect the biodegradation of the polymers. The 3 factors we will consider, that is morphological, chemical and physical factors. The morphological factors include shape and size. Next, variation of diffusion coefficient and mechanical stress. Chemical factors, the chemical structure and composition. Next, presence of ionic groups and the configuration structure. The last, molecular weight and presence of low molecular weight compounds. Physical factors includes processing conditions, sterilization process. And as in the earlier slide, I told the crystallinity is also playing a major role. Biodegradation is enzymatic hydrolysis or oxidation, and we know that landfilling of such polymers is a great problem. Now let's see the polymer degradation. Polymer degradation is a change in the properties, that is tensile strength, color, shape, etc. of a polymer or polymer based product under the influence of one or more environmental factors such as heat, light or chemicals. The term biodegradation is limited to the description of chemical process, changes that alter either the molecular weight or solubility of the polymer. Bioerosion, erosion may be restricted to refer to physical processes that result in weight loss of a polymer device. There are few mechanisms of biodegradable polymers. The biodegradation can take place by 3 ways. Number 1, it can be an enzymatic degradation, it can be a hydrolysis, it can be combination. The hydrolysis may be of 2 types. It can be bulk erosion or surface erosion. These polymers, the bioplastics which are available in the market, which undergoes chemical degradation by hydrolysis and oxo-biodegradable plastics, they undergo chemical degradation by oxidation. This results in their physical disintegration and a drastic reduction in their molecular weight. These smaller, low molecular weight fragments are amenable to biodegradation. They tend to degrade and biodegrade somewhat more quickly than oxo-biodegradable plastics in comparison to hydro-biodegradable plastics. The polymers generally OBP means, that is oxo-biodegradable plastics, they are generally less expensive and possess better physical properties and can be made with current plastics processing equipments. Whereas hydro-biodegradable plastics, they emit methane in anaerobic conditions, but the oxo-biodegradable plastics, they do not. Polyester plays a predominant role in hydro-biodegradable plastics due to their potential dehydrolyzed ester bonds. These hydrobiodegradable plastics can be made from agricultural resources such as corn, wheat, sugarcane and fossils. Whereas the oxo-biodegradable plastics, they are made as a byproducts of oil or natural gases. So various mechanisms are there for disintegration or degradation. The advantages of biodegradable polymers. They are utilized for localized delivery of drug, sustained delivery of drug, stabilization of drug, decrease in dosing frequency, reduced side effects, improved patient compliance, controllable degradation rate. The major application of biodegradable polymers. These biodegradable polymers are utilized for ocular, tissue engineering, vascular, orthopedics, skin adhesive and surgical glues. The biodegradable drug system for therapeutic agents such as anti-tumor, antipsychotic agents, anti-inflammatory agents. These polymeric materials are used in and on soil to improve aeration and promote plant growth and health. Mainly, many biomaterials, especially heart valves, replacements, and blood vessels are made of polymers like Dacron, Teflon, and polyurethane. They also utilize for gene therapy. So, they should be non-toxic in nature. They should have to maintain good mechanical integrity until they are degraded, and they should be capable of control rate of degradation. With this, I would like to finish my lecture. I hope that I am able to make you understand the theory, the major principles, and the detailing of the biodegradable polymers. Thank you so much.